All right, hello and welcome. We are getting straight back into it for Operation Glass Him. It is the operation to save Johannesburg, or save Johannesburg's train yard, which the guy from Mumbai designed, from the horrible threat of an alien terror attack. Yes, as you can tell by my voice, I'm still a little bit hyper and quite excited because I haven't stopped recording. I haven't stopped playing since the last mission, so I'm still in that same frame of mind, and I got a lot of mel on that mission. Anyway, actual mission critical stuff. Let's get down there, and let's talk about this map for a little bit, and then let's actually play the damn game.
Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike One has been given the green light. Your highest priority is to protect those civilians.
So let's take a look at what I'm thinking here. We're a close combat squad, a lot of shotguns, obviously, so there's a couple of reasons I'm avoiding the right, that's one of them. Obviously, you've got longer you've got longer avenues of engagement if you take the map long ways, because you're running down these long corridors, where if you take the map short ways, if you take it with these constant line of sight blockers and carriages in the way, it's better for close combat work. You're more likely to trigger things through doorways that are right next to you. Additionally, off the bat, it looks like there's a way more civilians on the left side than there are on the right. Now remember, we're here to save civilians, so obviously going on the left is going to let us rescue them quicker and faster. Of course, it also puts them more in the crossfire if we see aliens over there, but I think that's just a risk we have to take, and it should allow us to save more civilians faster by heading for the bulk of them. I've drawn additional red arrows here to designate if things go wrong. Obviously, ideally, we would commit to this left side and get all the way across the map before we draw a pod. But what if we draw a pod here, here, or perhaps even here? We're going to have to make alterations. Now, if we draw a pod in this leftmost area, that really scuppers our plan. If it's anything but chrysalids, we'd have to immediately get in these boxes and fight. And fight from this lamppost. That's not good. That would be a worst case for us. Additionally, if we take contact through this doorway, and it's in this kind of area, we'll have to immediately take cover and fight them here as well. Hopefully, and I know this doesn't sound like something you'd say about chrysalids, but hopefully any pod we activate early will be chrysalids, so we can deal with them early before they patrol into us later on, and also because it won't force us to take cover, and there's not a lot of cover in our future. There is not a lot of cover in our future on this left flanking run. It's really to get us into position more than it is a good way to go. And then hopefully stuff like floaters and sectoids and everything else, hopefully they can wait for the rest of the map over here, at which point we have oodles of cover to sit in and engage. So that's the plan. We're going to head left first. Now let's see who we'll lead with.
Moving out.
Alright, so far so good. No contact yet. So far, so good. Now, I'm tempted to dash to save these civilians, but as soon as you round this corner, you've entered a whole new level of possible line of sight activations from all these areas. So this is actually quite a dangerous corner to take, and we'll want to take it safely. No draws on the right. That's good.
On my way.
No draws on the right. That's very good. Catch up those slow pokes.
Location confirmed. Okay.
All right. Keep your shotgun Overwatch out, because even if you're thinking, well, shotgun Overwatch won't do anything because the floaters activate over here at range, just keep in mind that what you're really waiting for is the chrysalids to patrol into you and run right up to you, and you could potentially kill or maim several of them by keeping your shotguns ready at all times. Close and personal, an amazing perk for terror missions. Sad that we don't have any Lance Corporal assaults to make use of it here. Alright. The pigeons were there, but they've flown off. Obviously scared off by the growling sounds. Nope, here's some more pigeons. If you've never taken a good look with the new camera options of Long War, they may have cut a few corners regarding gaming computer power put towards making the animals seem lifelike. But to their credit, I honestly never noticed that this is how simplistic they were until I actually got down there. So, you know what? Good work. But I honestly just... Because obviously Vanilla didn't have zoom options like this. You never got to actually look at them. Look at this fucking... Oh, wait till you see the rats, man. The rats are golden. I hope this map has rats. I'm gonna show you the rats when I see them. Oh, man, the rats are even better. Anyway, sorry. Let's move up our running gunner first, I guess. Actually, no, don't move your infantry first. Move up our running gunner, save that civilian.
I'm rolling. You're clear. Move out.
You are clear, sir. Now I want to take a double bound. I'm in cover if it's a floater activation, and if it's a lit activation... Well, if it's a lit activation, I'm gonna have to grenade him. Oh, I really want to save that poor guy, but... I just don't know if it's worth it. It's unlikely for there to be a pod here, because that's the extent of the map. It's less likely, and... We've already really covered a lot of the line of sight problems here, so... Unless there was just a really nasty activation right here... Speed is the key with terror missions. You want to save as many people as you can. I could play it safe and come out of here with only a few civilians saved. Or maybe I could get crazy and come out of here with a lot saved. Let's go. Let's go for broke. Go for broke. Go for broke. Ha 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 ha!
Go! You're safe!
You gotta save the civilians, man. You can't just let the civilians die in droves like you used to. You've gotta get out there and you've gotta actually bring them home. I know it's crazy, but it's how it is now. The civilians actually matter a lot. So let's use the benefit of that full move to get other people dashed up in position as well. And we're not gonna have as much shotgun overwatch, but we will have more people in position, and that's good.
C-O-M, Rusam!
Unless a weird line of sight bug, it suddenly activates a really fringy activation, and I get really mad.
Solid copy, Commander.
Solid copy, Commander. Well, that's good. We're off to a good start here.
Yes, sir.
We're towing the line. We're playing it fast and loose. Emphasis on fast. Floaters right there.
There's something out there.
On the other side of that yellow container, probably a bit further away from how loud the noise was. Probably maybe on the other half of that. No, they were right there, they were right there. Okay, okay. Four floaters. Haven't spotted us yet? Wow, that's lucky. How do you deal with a whole shitload of floaters that haven't even seen you yet? Somehow. Holy shit, that's lucky. You should really be visible. Well, obviously, a cool way to start this off would be to AP grenade every single floater at once. That would certainly be handy. I'm down for that. I'm down for AP grenading every single floater at once. That seems like a good time to me. So I'm going to chuck this this little old AP grenade right there. And we're going to see what happens. Wow, that's absolute horseshit. I swear they were flashing. Okay, well, everyone is still hopefully grenadable. Didn't really accomplish too much with that, I'm afraid. Well, let's see here. There's a lot of Overwatch there to have to deal with. Who do we want in position where? Well, AO can move right here. What? And you can already see someone. Holy shit. But you can't see the guy I think you'd be able to see. Nope. Now, with four floaters activated in the bulk of the civilian populace, the onus is really on us to make sure that we kill them all quickly. Unfortunately, that's going to mean if another chrysalid pod is about to get activated, there's not all I can do about it. Great job. That's one down. Now it's time to deal with some of these overwatches, I think. So, we'll save one of these civilians off the bat. We're gonna trigger two overwatches at... Oh, it's fairly close range. I should find a better way to handle this. Maybe a gunner... Maybe a gunner could... No, a gunner's gonna get picked by the overwatch. Maybe a gunner on the left is gonna be able to hit one of these guys. Step out. You're not going to see anything, are you? I don't want to be hit by Overwatch, but I also need to be a smart player of the game here. Maybe if... I really need to deal with one of those Overwatches so that it's safer for my scout to run out there. I wish you could run left. If you could run left right here, that would be a much safer way to run out there. But if you run right, what if you trigger an Overwatch? What if... I could flashbang. I could indeed flashbang. And I can see one now. Interesting. So as you can see, that guy overwatching would have got a fairly close range overwatch on our gunner if I moved the gunner first. And it's still quite scary for the... Can I flashbang your buddy? Can I flashbang your buddy? No, I cannot. Okay. Super. Alright, so that plan is a little bit out the window. But hopefully I can figure out a way to gun him. Maybe if I step out to the left, I'll be able to see him.
Moving.
Yes. Okay. Super. So we're going to suppress one.
Aye, aye.
We've committed a lot of our squad now, so we don't want to reveal too much ground to that left side, or we're liable to trigger chrysalids, which would be bad right now. Oh, man. Chrysalids right now would be really bad. Oh, God. What if there's chrysalids there? How the fuck am I going to deal with this? Oh no, this is bad. Run the SM here.
Roger.
Trigger one overwatch at decent range. Hey, good job. I'm glad I didn't trigger the other one. Woo, no lids. Lids no lidding. So we've got one suppressed. Now we still need to kill that suppressed one because that suppressed one is going to shoot a civilian and aim. I think they always hit civilians. The aim penalties won't really matter to him. We need to run someone to deal with these other two floaters as well. Take as much cover as we can here to do that, I think. And maybe even another grenade. Well, let's see. I could run an assault out here to flank this close proximity floater if I can kill the other two. And that's going to rely on judicious use of grenades. Oh, I could flashbang both of them. Look at that. Hey, what do you know? Well, what do you know? Okay. Yeah, actually, a good AP grenade on these two might be better. I don't know. Well, this one's easy to flank, so maybe not. If I run my grenadier out to the left. Ah, no! No, 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 no. No, 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 wow, that was the few extra tiles of reveal that kills you. Chrysalid through a doorway coming this summer. Oh, shit, that's really bad. Distance, give me distance. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that front chrysalid is going to be able to engage my gunner. To limit the hell here. Okay, we're gonna have a flashbang. We are going to have to assault with extreme prejudice. I'm gonna be okay. Move here first. Let's actually get inside our gunner and share the spot with her.
Look out.
And that way, without getting any closer, without giving the chrysalids any more chances to hit, we are hopefully making it so that the assault with one more health, I believe, than the gunner, is more likely to be, you know, hit than otherwise. Now we must kill this chrysalid. He must die. We absolutely must kill the chrysalid. Oh, Nelly. This is just not what you want to have happen. I should have, I think while still playing fast and loose, perhaps what I should have done is moved my grenadier first, but then I didn't know. I just canceled the suppressions. I don't know. I guess it just really goes to show that, you know, even though I want to play these terror missions faster and looser, you're still going to get punished for it.
Okay.
Close and personal would save some lives right about now. It really would, guys. It would save a lot of lives. Oh, sorry, is it close combat specialist? It's close combat specialist. I can never tell those apart. So if this 82% misses, we're fucked. Thank God. Okay, so we're still probably pretty fucked. But what we're betting on here is the fact that flashbangs will lower the mobility of these chrysalids, cutting it in half. And hopefully that is just enough. Plus this civilian, which I am rather in a cavalier fashion now using as a meat shield. Hopefully they will kill the civilian with this front runner, and then the other two will have not enough movement to get to me. But chrysalids have a lot of movement, so we don't know it's going to go that way. Whatever happens, it's been an honor, guys. It's been an honor having a campaign that thus far has gone pretty good. I guess eventually my luck had to run out, and I think you're about to see that right now. So the gunner can't kill any more lids, and the gunner is too close. Even flashbanged, I know that front lid will definitely get the gunner. The engineer. So we'll move the engineer back into a covered position. There's probably no safe place to put her where this right one won't see them, unless I run this way. So let's run this way.
Headed there now.
Oh God, faith in Jesus. Oh fuck. That front one's gonna be able to get me. That front lid is gonna be able to get me. Oh my God, it's gonna be able to get me. Civilians are dying in droves. That's zombies next turn. Panic will make those zombies much more effective at killing me. Oh shit. Oh God, fuck. Oh, fuck. Okay, now I've still got people sitting in no cover and there's floaters who can see them. So we're not out of the woods yet. We could take... Oh God, close proximity shots with the floaters. This guy is gonna shoot my exposed soldier. Oh, you did your best, Cell. You did your damn best. But where is he gonna go? Where's he gonna run to? Oh, he can't see anyone. Holy shit. And now it's the last flashbang floater. What's he gonna do? Oh! My God. I don't even care about the four extra floaters. Oh. My kingdom for a rocketeer. So we got out of that just about as safely as we could have. Now, things are going bad for the civilians, but we can get out of here. And live to keep fighting. And now we've got a chrysalid here. Chrysalid quite up close, and a chrysalid on the right. What can AOE see? Not a lot. Okay, so our greatest weapon against the chrysalids here, explosive damage, you know, apart from shotguns, is not going to be useful because we've given them the turn to all spread out because we couldn't deal with them on the first turn. So that makes things like... Oh man, our engineer's in a real bad spot, hey? The engineer needs to run away from this chrysalid, but... Oh, and we could grenade these fuckers! Except for this chrysalid on the... On the side here is in the way. He's right there. Now, we could potentially kill that chrysalid. We could run someone... to the left here and kill this chrysalid of shotguns. But once we commit to engaging these chrysalids, we commit to engaging these chrysalids. We can't run away from them. So can we kill them all this turn? Well, this guy's pretty damn shotgunnable. Okay, he's pretty shotgunnable over there. That's all right. This one, also incredibly shotgunnable. This one on the right, fairly shotgunnable. And in a pinch, I can throw an AP grenade at him. Probably kill both him or finish both him and the floater off. That's going to leave this guy. The floaters are not as big a threat right now. I can overwatch them. I can scare them. But you can't overwatch chrysalids into being scared. That's not going to fly. So we've got a lot of shotguns. And we've got rifles and grenades to back them up. As you can see, I can grenade this chrysalid. Oh, I can grenade this chrysalid and grenade those floaters. And I can grenade this one. I can grenade all of them. So, I mean, between all my AoE damage and the fact that there's nowhere to run to... And... Oh, no. Wait. No. John. No, the zombies. The zombies, John. John, the zombies are gonna get you. Oh, shit. So I need to get away. I always make this mistake. And thank God I actually remembered it just now before I started making moves. These guys killed by chrysalids are gonna get up and start doing shit against me. And they can move like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 even. They can move. Oh man, that really puts a damper on everything. Oh, everything was perfect until I realized that. Now, I've heard tell that if you engage these bodies with explosives, the zombie no longer happens, but I'm not really willing to test that right now, and I hope you can appreciate why. So this completely changes our beautiful plan. Now we have pretty shitty options to engage the chrysalids because we have to get away from them because of the zombies. And at the same time, our engineer is stuck over there. Now, if we weren't facing the floaters, we could just sit in the open, but that's not how it is. We are facing the floaters, and we need to get away. Oh man, this is bad. We could have wiped them all out. I could HE grenade these guys. No, I don't have enough HEs because the right one. Fuck me. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? These zombies are terrible. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, behind these barrels should be safe from this zombie that's about to rise. This poor woman who has now become, or is about to become the undead. So I can potentially get a shotgun shot on that chrysalid from there. So that can be numero uno. Although I need to run these overwatches for this engineer to get away. Man, that's a bitch. Fucking... Just let me shoot him in the head now while they're down and we wouldn't have this problem. No cover for anybody. Wow. It's because they've unilaterally put a zombie here, here, and here. That's the problem. I can run off to the border of the map, but then... You know, like... Floaters gonna get me. This is bad. We just gotta start taking shots, I think. I need this lid dead as hell. Wow. Ewo, you're a strong man. That's why I bring you. Alright. Man. So now I think I'm gonna have to run this Engineero back. And Robert de Engineero is gonna have to HE grenade this lid's cover, which is gonna allow people to stand back away from the floaters while still getting the shot. Then I still gotta deal with this little bitch though. Well, we stand out in the open here to not get shot by the floaters on the left, and we're gonna get shot by the floater on the right. That's a problem. Perhaps what needs to happen instead is run the engineer here, throw an HE. This HE is gonna blow up this guy's, oh no, even an AP. Throw an AP, that's gonna hopefully kill this guy. I was gonna say an HE to blow up his cover, but probably smarter is an AP. Oh, but an HE could potentially kill that zombie before it rises. And is liable to do as much damage, minus one, and is gonna blow up the cover. And it may even blow up the cover of that crystal on the left. It's agonizing, but I think I'm gonna take that grenade first. So what we do here is we would run the scout to, let's say this position, maybe? Yeah, sure, let's... I don't know, that's dangerous to get flanked on if the floater gets a brain in his head. No one else can even make it to this position, so... Let's just put the scout right about here.
Okay.
All hands on deck for this one. And now we're going to need the grenade of the century, really. No sapper, so, you know, we're in a little bit of trouble already there. Oh man, I mean, if I blow up this doorway, I'm letting the floaters see my exposed guys more, too. One, two, three, four, five, six. Counting with Beagle. The mission, the video. Maybe it would just be safer to try and engage this chrysalid, or maybe even just safer to just flashbang this one. I don't know, man. Like, it's just not looking great. Toothcake, can you go? No, you can't. Toothcake, you can't even get anywhere to fucking flashbang him. Gonna have to stay in the goddamn open again. Gonna have to stand in the goddamn... What if it doesn't hit? What if it doesn't hit the guy? Holy shit, I'm in trouble. I'm in so much trouble. Run, Toothcake, back. Shotgun. Potentially suppress this right floater. And then... flashbang the left chrysalid? Yeah? And not get shot by Overwatchers, hopefully. I think that's gonna be the ticket today. I could potentially just get back and... Oh, I mean, it's not likely to hit. I could potentially just get back and flashbang him. Maybe that's what I gotta do. the pain. Well, this guy couldn't see this this guy, so maybe he's gonna have shitty line of sight and I can get away with standing back here. Here's hoping, I guess. Because hope's really all I got. Okay, you can't be seen by the right floater. Great. Awesome. If you could flashbang both of these cats, that'd be great. But that's kind of the right side dealt with for now. Now the last thing we have to deal with is the left. And I'm about to have to run some Overwatches, which you never want to do. But they're going to be necessary to safely position myself and also throw that flashbang, I think. Well, hell, if I'm flashbanging this lid, I can position myself here and engage the floaters that are on this corner. Maybe even engage this zombie. This is just bad shit. This is just fucking bad shit. It's bad shit. But maybe I can throw a nade over, kill or maim some of those floaters, if I'm lucky with the throw here. Stepping out and throwing, and then maybe that'll take some of the heat off.
On my way.
Okay. Fling true, sweet AP grenade.
Suck on this.
The one thing that could make this all go wrong, not enough damage, is if my assaulter gets hit and in the process panics. And then there's no one left to flashbang this left chrysalid. And the shit is going to hit the fan if that happens. But at this point, in fact, even because of that, I should throw this flashbang first. Just in case Toothcake's one of the people who panics. Obviously, we don't want another lid on our hands. So we're going to have to flashbang. This is just not safe play you're seeing right here today. Let me tell you. You're probably going to have to overwatch. Or maybe you'll be able to over... No, you're liable to get fucked up. Oh, man. It all comes down to the run. Unless I simply position around here and I probably can still flashbang. It's probably safer, you know, all told. If I sit about there and flashbang... probably actually safer. That's going to be for the zombie. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah, it's not safer if the zombie can reach me. Aha. And then we're starting to get out of flashbang range. Right now you can flash to that corner. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's getting on the extent of the range, isn't it? I wouldn't trust it. I think I've just got to take it. I've just got to take the hits. They're nasty hits. They're going to be painful. But as long as I don't die and I don't panic, we will emerge.
Heading to that location.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Incoming fire.
Jesus! Take fighters one. But we live. Somehow. I wish this flashbang counted to the zombie that was about to get up, but we all know it doesn't. So yeah, glad I brought all these flashbangs today, that's for sure. Okay, so you're gonna get booped. And finally, after a long amount of hooing and hawing and fear in general, we get to see the results, the spoils, if you will, of this turn. Now what can they gonna do considering that Her services are not needed to oh yeah, you need to suppress that floater, that's right. Okay. So Gunner, you better run about, let's say, maybe here? This is all gonna come apart, of course, if the floaters come out and shoot my guys in no cover, but I feel like it's the best I can do right now. I feel like it's really the best I can do for way of a plan. So we don't wanna go any more left because that makes the floaters on the left more likely to see us, so we're just gonna have to go here.
Okay.
And hoo boy howdy, that's just gonna have to do. We're gonna suppress you, I think. And hopefully if you take a shot at us, we scare you. Otherwise, you know, good shit. I could just take a shot in this scenario. But if it misses, I don't want to leave a floater that's willing to just run up and shoot me. I want to suppress him so that he either takes a shot in shit cover or he's forced to run, dash away from me because he's scared. So I'm going to go for suppression here. All right, this is it. Now you guys just need to keep him busy this turn, I think. Yes, an HE grenade here could potentially... maybe an HE just to test it, just to see if we can stop additional zombies from happening. Oh, but I really need that Overwatch to keep him scared, to keep him mean. That's a hard choice, man. I think I'll go with an HE, both to test the zombie thing. No, but if I get rid of the heavy cover, he'll be able to see. No, don't do that. Let's just see if we can kill him with an AP, I think. And Overwatch of the other guy. Okay, okay. Whatever that means, yes. Ah, you little son of a poop tang, alright. You gotta Overwatch, you gotta keep him scared. That is, have your Overwatch ruined by this zombie getting up. Oh my god, look at them all. Man, we'd be looking at the wiped squad if I had, if I'd forgotten about those zombies getting up. Okay, so, that's good. Flashbang Chrysalid not doing a lot over there. And, that's also pretty good. Two Chrysalids not doing a lot. All comes down to those floaters hitting my exposed troops. Because as you can see... Ah, there goes my Overwatch! Nothing you can do. As you can see, that zombie, even if I was a tile closer, would have pulverized me. So I think I made the safest calls I could have. You know what? Cover's great, but sometimes you can't have it. And this is one of those times. We're still seeing if I'm going to be punished for the curse of the... Look at that movement. For the curse of the greedy terror mission. It's all down to the floaters now. Thank God you didn't panic, because we don't need panickers right now. We need problem solvers. Okay, who can you see? You're on Overwatch. Who can you see? You're on Overwatch. You're killing a civilian. What are you doing? You're killing a civilian that was about to get chrysalided, that's fine. What are you gonna do? Nothing. Okay. There, by the grace of God, walks XCOM. So we've still got big problems. One of them is the zombies are now coming for us. The other is we are still trapped by Overwatch. What are the good things that happened that turn? Well, the chrysalids have clustered for grenades. That's obviously very good. We can potentially double AP grenade them now. What else is bad? Well, we've got three zombies in our face, and we're still liable to be killed by all these floaters. But this zombie should be killable pretty easily by AWO because he's got the boom boom pow. This zombie should be dealable, withable, because it's too far from where I can run to. The main problem is ballistics can't run from these overwatches. Ballistics is pinned right now. And I really don't trust Ballistic's position unless we can kill this zombie. And even if we kill this one, we would have to kill both zombies for Ballistic's to be safe in this position. So how are we going to deal with this? Well, we don't want to be running any overwatches of our Lightning Reflexes Scout when the Lightning Reflexes Scout is on 2 health. So I feel like what we need to do here And if we don't kill these chrysalids, they're going to be unflashbang next turn, and they're going to be coming straight for us, so... Worst case, we have to run Overwatches again. Ah, that's going to be horrible. Can I... No, I need to use my grenades for the... Fucking chrysalids! Unless I have more flashbangs? No. And that leaves things in question if the grenades don't successfully kill those chrysalids, like... Things in question, like, what do I do about the chrysalids? Man, this is a shit sandwich, and it's all because those floaters are pinning me with their Overwatch. Smart floaters. Very smart floaters. What I might have to do is pull the Overwatch with somebody else. But everybody else needs to shoot. Everybody else needs to shoot. Everybody else needs to shoot. Oh, shit. And if I move to the right to grenade the chrysalids, that zombie's gonna get me. So this zombie has to die. Oh, what if I was to hold my ground here? Bet on a big critical dealing like 10 damage. And then an LMG finishing him off. That's still not enough. Too many enemies, not enough ways to deal with it. So how do we deal with it? Well, the chrysalids are pretty far from everyone else. So maybe our saving grace with these chrysalids is that if we ignore them for this turn... Ignore chrysalids, I know, not good. Maybe if we ignore them for this turn, they won't be able to reach us. And then we can focus on priority zombies and floaters. Which would be this guy, obviously. If we were to move left and throw an AP, we could potentially deal with two floaters. In fact, we could potentially deal with both the overwatching floaters with the right toss. Maybe we'll start with that with our Grenadier, right? We're going to go Operation Ignore the Chrysalids for now. Ignore Chrysalids. I know, guys, but I feel like it's the best we got. So as you can see, we're only going to get two of them. What might be smarter here is to use one of our HE grenades, stick it in a place where it's going to get decent damage on everyone, and it's also going to be right on that forklift, meaning if we get very lucky, the forklift will explode this turn. Unlikely. What's more likely is that the forklift will be set on fire. And in this way, we should hopefully maybe kill a floater. If not, we're going to make their day very bad. So that's a good start, I think. So let's deal with this floater issue as best we can.
Frag out.
Come on, big explosion. Oh, well, one's dead. It's pretty good. Well, the forklift isn't even on fire, but one of them is dead, so I can't complain too much. And that's suddenly much, okay, well, they're both still overwatching. I was going to say it's suddenly much better if it's minus two overwatches, but, you know how it goes. Now, I feel like the safest move to make next is going to be maybe shooting this guy. Yeah, maybe. But for it to be truly safe, I need to kill that chrysalid. And who else can kill that chrysalid? No one from this position. AOE's got a terrible accuracy shot of it, which just isn't good enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, AOE can run back to this corner, and AOE will be fine from the zombie, but what about the lids? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That should be okay. Seems like maybe the safest choice we could make would be to fall back to this cover and then shoot the close zombie. But what could come out really well for us, if we play the odds here, is 39%, maybe hit and critically wound that zombie. That could take him down to a level where Ballistics can finish him off. Then Ballistics doesn't have to run. Ballistics doesn't have to potentially die to floater Overwatch again. Then everyone else, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, fuck, because then everyone else has to kill this zombie. Holy shit, goddammit. I'm going to have to go sit my ass in no cover again. It's going to happen. Gonna have to run right back here, grenade that floater's cover. What's your diagonal throw range, son? It's important. You can throw to the extent of these boxes. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you'd want to be about here to get a good HE grenade, or maybe even here. That's well out of zombie range, well out of chrysalid range. And it is going to let you... Is it out of the range? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's actually not quite out of zombie. Fuck my life. It's not quite out of zombie range. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow. Oh, there's just no good things going on today at all. Okay, so I think to be truly safe, I actually have to kill this zombie. Okay, we'll take your first shot. It's good damage, son. See if you can finish him off. Can you get away from this zombie? Well, surely you can move further than a zombie, right? You're a fucking gunner. That'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm not convinced, actually. What if we move, like, here? I need to kill this fucking zombie. Is what it comes down to. The floaters are still going to gauge this guy, so hopefully we're safe where we are. Need to move so this floater doesn't shoot me, but apart from that, I think I'm just going to kill this fucking floater. This fucking zombie, I mean. And then we're going to grenade that fucker. And then we can take another shot with the AOS. That's good. No, wait, no, we can't because there's chrysalids. Damn it! Things keep getting worse. You're just going to have to move a little bit right, not get seen by that floater anymore. And then kill the zombie! That floater can see you now, so he definitely has to die. Kill the zombie! Thank God, you're a trooper. When will I ever get to use cover again? Is a real question I'm facing right now. So that leaves two zombies left. But they're zombies we can kill easily, which means now I can HE this Floaterino. Yeah. Die. Fucking die. Great. He even wounded the crystal a little bit. Okay. Now, we still gotta run from the chrysalids. Another flashbang would have bought us some much-needed time at this point. Hey, bonus! My scout's about to have a pretty safe odds at pulling, like, a 1% shot at pulling this Overwatch safely. That floater should have a 1% on me if he can see me move. Which is pretty safe. Probably want to move back to, like, here, maybe? That should be out of chrysalid range. 1, 2, 3, 4, a lot of counting. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It's worse than the other position, that's for sure, but, beggars kind of can't be choosers, but then again, I could just run right back here, and the floaters are probably not going to get in range to see me. Okay, so do that. You're pulling one Overwatch. Right, you're not pulling two. This is really handy for me. And you're killing a zombie. Great. Okay, now, did I open myself up to any new floaters? No, that's really lucky. Haha, that one little bit there didn't come open. That's insanely lucky. Okay, so now it all comes down to the last Overwatch. Obviously not running it would be ideal, but let's get real here. No one can kill this zombie. Unless... I can't suppress, I don't have enough ammo. Can you see that zombie? No one can see that zombie. I guess these telegraph poles are line of sight blockers. Interesting. Should have stood behind them more. I probably just need to get in position here and shoot a lid or something. Okay. Oh, I can't see anyone now. Fuck. Okay. So, you're going to have to reload.
Good to go.
You're gonna have to run ballistics. You're gonna have to run like the fucking wind. And Awa's gonna have to run too. I think I might just be in range of one of those lids, but what else can I do at this point? Okay, so running like the wind, operation go. 1, 2, 3. I'm sorry for all the counting. It's like Sesame Street. 4, 5, 6. Let's not risk it. Let's run all the way over here. Maybe into this position. This position will be good. So, for things to go well, because we don't want panic to start happening, all we need is for ballistics to dash through this Overwatch with the appropriate dash penalty to his hit chance to hit. We just need to dash through this to get away from the zombie and not die. The mission could come down to this.
Stepping off.
Ballistics, come on. Duck and weave. Oh, yeah. Get out of there. And shoot that zombie. Okay, we're still in a lot of trouble here. Still got people flanked in the open. As I said at the start of the mission, Oh god, another zombie. As I said at the start of the mission, there's not a lot of cover on this side, and, well, it sure is turning out to be the true, the way we've made contact. Another zombie to come. Now the real threat is the floaters discovering my guys out in the open. Will we get punished for it? We're about to find out. Let's hope they fight the visible threats first. Close and personal would have killed these zombies, or close combat specialists would have killed these zombies by now. I really wish we had it. Okay, so we're fighting who we can see right now.
I'm under fire.
These large containers, luckily, not going to blow up. Oh shit! You're behind a container. You can't see him because you're behind a container. Fuck me! Is that a
need to find some new cover.
What? Whoa! You can move really far. Oh, it's all going to hell now. Well, there go both the assaults. Well, you know what? People always say I've got a lot of luck. That luck had to run out at some point. Now we're in a lot of trouble. That's both assaults down, and Ballistics is going to follow them because that zombie's going to kill him. We just went down to about 4 people left on this terror mission. I'm absolutely amazed that the floater was able to... Damn. Wow, that's rough. Okay, so, yeah, this ain't going good now. This ain't going good at all. Got another zombie about to come out here. We had a floater. We have 4 floaters still remaining in play. Ballistics is about to get chomped by a zombie. I don't think I can save him. I don't think there's any way to save Ballistic from that zombie. The only thing I could do would be to run out into the open and Overwatch. And in doing so, just opening myself up to the fact that A, the Overwatch is likely to miss, B, it's likely to not do enough damage, and C, all the floaters are going to get free shots at me. I might actually not be able to save Ballistics at this point. His panic might have just killed him. But I'll be damned if I'll lose this mission after all these people have sacrificed their lives, so we need to start thinking about that too. Good god. This is an absolute horror show here tonight on the Mumbai train yard, as is quite common for this fucking train yard. Maybe if I move right here I could Overwatch. It's not gonna be enough. It's not gonna be in range. I can't save him. I cannot save him. I hate having to say that, but I cannot save him. Fuck. Okay, well, let's start thinking. We've got all the floaters bottled up on the left right now. So I guess we need to exploit that while we still can. Now, AO's gonna need shotgun ammo to deal these chrysalids, who are currently running rampant, killing as many civilians as they can. Hopefully that'll buy us some time to deal with them by falling back and reloading. Falling back into the reload. Falling back into an Overwatch, probably with DSM. Hypergeek can't move. And Cell might just have to suppress the closest floater from her current position. God, I hope that doesn't put her in range of a chrysalid. That should be out of range. 1, 2, 3, 4, counting com. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Don't really trust that very much. But otherwise, I'm in zero cover against that floater, and that's not a fun place to be. If I can move Hypergeek, I can take his cover, but, yeah, not the case. I think I'm just gonna have to bet on it being good enough.
Okay.
So this is going to be an operation that goes down in bloody history at how it's progressing, and we can already see.
You see there.
Ooh, that's right, that lid run over here. It's going to kill that civ though, probably. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 layers. I gotta reload, man. I have to reload. Don't know what you want me to tell you. I have to reload in this position.
I'm on it, Commander.
Shit, this is bad times, man. This is real bad times.
Got him covered.
I didn't have to reload, but it seems unlikely that this right one will come for me. It seems like it's gonna get that civilian, so. Unless this chrysalid kill steals him. We're about to find out. I should still be out of range, let's hope. Okay, we're still good with the chrysalids. That's another zombie to the pain train. I wish they just run fucking at me in one of the turns. I was ready for them already. Woo! You're lucky, ballistics. Now we gotta fight to save ballistics. This is better for ballistics, but probably worse for the outcome of this mission. More floaters. I know that's not very nice to say, but if Ballistics was just dead, we could fall back and forget that he existed and focus on saving live people. But that is not the case, as you can see right here. Now we have to actually worry about him. And the only way to save Ballistics would be to fight this turn, dash next turn, and heal the turn after that. And I'd have to dash to like here, so we need to have an amazing turn right now to be able to do that. How am I going to have an amazing turn, guys? How am I going to make that happen? Well, I could HE grenade these two. That's going to deal a little damage to one, and it's going to explode the cover of and kill the other one. That leaves one, two, potentially three. I believe there was an additional floater. So that leaves three floaters still active. I don't know where the fucking chrysalids went, so I kind of just got to fall back from the chrysalids. I don't know where the fuck they are, but I'm not happy about it. Maybe I could move like here and see where they are and potentially move up my guys. I need my guys in position to, let's say we kill this one with an HE, then I'd probably suppress one. And then move my guys up to flank him next turn. So man. Ballistics, you're in so much trouble. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's move back first, find those lids. Right, I got one lid pretty close, but if I can kill that one, it's good. It's good if I can kill that one. But otherwise, he's probably in range to kill me. So maybe I should fall back. Because my scout isn't quite close enough to take a shot on him. And that's going to be telling. Maybe I just got to deal with that. Just got to deal with that this turn. You've got to throw your little grenade. You've got to throw your little grenade here. Okay. This is a real horror show. This mission must have been going for ages now. I'm sorry. You can throw your little grenade here and probably kill one and potentially kill the other. In fact, almost certainly kill one and potentially kill the other. So that's good. You can do that. You can do that. Alright. Do that. This is our last grenade. One down. I don't really have the... I really can't suppress. I really need to keep shooting. One, two, three, four, five, six. Fucking zombie's probably in range to hit me. But if he wasn't, I could flush that floater and deal with that problem right now. I want that flush so bad, but I feel like it's going to put me in zombie range. Fuck. And I just can't quite get to good cover either. I'm in hell. I'm still in hell. One, two, three, four, five, six. There's nowhere I can go to get the flush without also being exposed. Unless... unless I move like here.
I'm on the move.
Great, now I can't see anyone. Awesome. You gotta shoot. Yep.
Negative damage.
You're gonna have to fall back. Hey Sal, yeah, you have literally nowhere to run to. So what do you want me to tell you, man? Just like fucking shoot a zombie, because you actually can't run anywhere. This is really coming down to the fact that this left side of the map just does not have cover. That's a lid now. Just what I needed. The lid's gonna kill every civilian on the map. Oh, there's a rat! I told you. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can move 5. Shit, I could have been in that position. I could have been in that lack of cover, and it would have been okay. We're gonna need some luck to make it through this. Hopefully that zombie blocks the shot for the floater, though. Maybe. Okay. And like I told you, can we make it? So if we want to save ballistics, which would be nice, but is looking pretty unlikely, we would have to dash here, exploit the fact that there is no line of sight, and then revive him. And you know what? It really doesn't look like that's going to be realistic when you look at the shit that's happening right now. We're just going to have to win the mission at this point. I can't get the ballistics. I can't get him. And that means killing this chrysalid and killing that zombie. So we could move to cover if they're both dead, but if they're not both dead, we're gonna do. How the fuck am I gonna kill them? I almost just have to dash away.
Okay.
Okay, is there a chrysalis lid around here? Or are we gonna be good? Hopefully we're gonna be good. You're not dead yet. So yet again, I'm going to have to sit out in very little cover to get a good shot of them, I think. I could run up here. Yeah, I could do that. Alright. I don't know where the other lid went. I'm pretty sure it ran off, didn't it? Hey, why did I run up here? What if it doesn't do enough damage to kill? Sometimes I'm a real fucking stupid idiot. Fuck, that's dumb. That's one less shot I'm gonna get against it. Now I'm just gonna fall back more. Can't risk that zombie walloping another squad member if worst comes to worst.
Location confirmed.
I'm so sorry, ballistics. We have to get out. Oh, there's nothing we can do. We've gotta save who we can save at this point, and we couldn't save you. That's 3 soldiers down on 1 terror mission. I guess the only saving grace is that they're all low rank. You're a chrysalid next turn, you need to die. Oh, I'm glad I didn't take that cover spot. Wow. And you're probably about to become a chrysalid. Now I need people to not panic when that soldier bleeds out. Oh shit. So AO for the first time will hopefully actually get this double shotgunning business to be useful. Let's see, we've got shotguns for you, shotguns for you, shotguns for you. I think worst case, we can do this. And suppress that floater. Good. Good. This is good. This is good times.
Position confirmed.
Got a flank on that floater now if I wanted it. What I want is a dead zombie. And the only weapon of the damage to reliably do that is going to be the shotgun, I think. Assault rifle's obviously going to kill the chrysalid. So it'd be down to an HMG, and you know that LMG isn't going to do enough. So I'm just going to have to kill this guy. Don't miss, or we're fucked. Good. And now I have to use my remaining troops to finish him off. It's a shame. I'd like to, you know, use him to do other shit, but such is life. Can't really end the turn on the left cover here. Or I can and will be mutilated by a flanking floater. Big deal there. Big problem. Now, the floater can't see you, Sal, so... perhaps what I can do here...
Heading there now.
Oh, tell me you can see that fucking son of a bitch! Son of an absolute bitch. Really? Really? You can't see the... fuck me. Okay, that's not good. Now I have to take that position. I don't want to lose a fourth soldier on this mission. But what? But with how finicky the line of sight is on this fucking zombie,
position confirmed.
I don't have a lot of choice. This is gonna be bad, guys. It's coming in. Everyone's gonna need to deal with those. If that floater has half a brain, he's about to punish us. Floater coming in on my right. Ballistics is about to bleed out. He does. And... fuck me! That's something else. Oh, you little son of a bitch. Rip ballistics. No grenades left. Boy, we are in a bad situation. What can I do? Suppression and overwatch on me. That's going to be two reaction shots. I can't kill these lids. I'm out of shotgun ammo, for God's sake. Are even more people going to fall to this terror mission? Maybe. You're going to have to run it, geek. We're gonna have to run it, and we're gonna have to fight. If fighting is what you must do to achieve victory, then you must fight. Sun Tzu said that. Well, you can draw one of these overwatches, actually, thankfully. So you can run one, and then we can all get ready for Chrysalidopalooza.
Stepping off.
We're just gonna have to hope this doesn't hit. And we're just gonna have to eat a suppression as the floaters and chrysalids work together to hurry us down. Chrysalids aren't that big a deal to deal with on their own, but when you're already engaged with melee units, that's when they become a problem. I mean, when you're already engaged with ranged units, that's when it becomes a problem. And this all comes down to moving to this position here and activating the pack before we were done with the floaters. We would have dealt with these chrysalids much easier in any other activation. It's really just sad, you know? It's really just sad. Oh yeah, and there's a floater there. Right. Yeah, I'm gonna do something to him. Not. Alright, get the hell out of there, people. You're there. And you're gonna have to run a suppression, my friend. Run now while he's reloading. Woo! Lucky day, lucky day. I hope those lids can't reach me, but we're down to hopes at this point. The dreams are gone, it's down to hopes. Please hit. Good job. Oh, fuck. Nice. Oh. Make yourself visible. Oh, you little shit, you're not visible. You're gonna make me come get you. Floater incoming on my left. Okay, so this chrysalid needs to be dead, and I only have one man with shotgun shells left remaining to do it. So AOA's gonna have to move up here. Shotgun. Dies, maybe move right and pistol, or finish off the chrysalid with a pistol. That leaves Hypergeek to run right and point blank assault rifle this guy, and Cell to flush that floater. Alright, so you've got to go there first.
You see there.
Okay, so they're both there. That's strange that the other one was invisible until now. But you've still got to kill him. Good job. Maybe we'll actually not lose anyone else. I can only hope. It's going to leave dies to move into position. Maybe here? Maybe we'll just move right and reload.
That's affirmative.
I don't think my pistol would have the range to kill that one. You, oh, 89%, Christ. But you didn't let me down. Good job. That's going to leave you to... it's going to take all your ammo, but it is potentially a kill.
Out you go.
One damage, unlucky.
Guns dry. Reloaded.
And still they come. Floater exposing himself. Floater advancing on me, this one's going to take a shot. Yeah, man. Yeah, I feel ya. Got another one. Overwatch. Okay. Barring any zombies, this might actually be it for enemies right now. Luckily, we're finally in a position where we can stay still and we don't have to keep falling back. Except for AO, he's in a little bit of a pickle. But everyone else is fine. So, you could kill this floater on the right. Preferably with your pistol, save some ammo. That'd be good. That'd be real good. Is it better to use my rifle? No. So you could potentially kill this guy and save some ammo to boot. That's not how the game works. Can you kill the guy on the right? Can you see him? No, you can't. Alright. 25 to hit through a box. 38 to hit with a shotgun. It's gonna come down to dies running up and shotgunning, I think, on the right. Not where you want to put a 2-health scout, but... not a whole lot of options to deal with this right guy right now. If I don't get the range bonus and the guy doesn't die, I'm in a lot of trouble. So I kind of have to run up and get the best possible shot, I think.
Roger that.
Luckily no one can see me yet, but at least this ensures that he will die. Did I call Dark Souls Master Dies? I have Dies on the brain. Dies42, the person who makes the nameless generator and helped me format and code my stuff better. Not Dies as in will die. I can't even tell what I was saying anymore. We'll take a pistol shot for free. AOA, you're a strong man, and that's just what we needed. Now you can overwatch slash hunker. In this position, if these floaters are smart enough to go right, they're going to shoot a half-cover scout anyway. So perhaps the smartest thing to do in this situation will be to overwatch to scare them. Floaters are notoriously scared of overwatch. Hopefully it'll prove true here. Yeah, wow, they are fucking scared of overwatch. That is... that's probably a bug. They're probably not that scared of Overwatch. Works for me. Let's move up and engage these sons of bitches. They're just in a moment of awe that the humans continue to fight, I guess. So let's move up and let's continue to fight. 53 is not bad. Hey, good job. That's a dead floater combined with flush. Gonna pull the assault rifle. A hit here wins. Yep, that's it. That is it. Now, the flush is... Well, the flush could miss, I guess. But at 81, I'm betting on it. There you go.
Mission accomplished.
Good God. Operation Glass Hymn. Well, we will be saying and singing hymns for the three operatives lost on this most bloody of terror missions and our most bloody mission to date. I'm sure there will be a lot of interesting discussion in the comments on the mistakes made in activating those chrysalids early. I'm sure there will be no end of discussion on what people would have done differently and how they would have handled the situation. But, you know what? At the end of the day, war is hell. People die. I'm not saying it's not my fault, but, you know, I've got to move on if I have any hope of winning the alien war. I've got to put this behind me. And I've got to be happy that, at the very least, we saved 10 people's lives out there. And we only lost 3 troops, and there's still 4 more ready to carry on their name. Good God, though, that was quite a horror show. Very scary map for a terror mission. Lots of Scooby-Doo shit. Lots of doors that you run past and accidentally activate on. That's the worst mission I've had in a long time on this YouTube campaign or not. 3 soldiers dead.
No one was expecting this. They were some of our best. I wish there was more we could have done.
I do too. So there's promotions to be done, and there's things to be thought about. But I think instead of ending things at the usual mission start point, this week I'll pull another thing I did at the start of April where I end it in the base phase. Oh man, South Africa's still not happy.
We will be in touch, Commander.
At least they're not a panic level.
I'm sure the troops will be eager to get out there and even up the body count.
Damn right. So, I'll end it here for now, and we'll pick up next week. Oh, not next week, excuse me. I'm used to the Twitch campaign. We'll pick up in a day or so, or a couple days. We'll pick up when we pick up, and yeah, we'll see you again for the next episode. But I hope you enjoyed. Catch you next time.